Still, we do not know exactly what is the meaning of sequence similarity or distance between the two DNA sequences. As we already studied about the Hamming distance, and we cannot use this Hamming distance technique to compare the two DNA sequences. As we know that the Hamming distance technique is very important for the computational science problems, but this technique cannot be used for bioinformatics or biological problems. If we use strictly the Hamming distance technique, the calculations will show us that the ith position of any nucleotide in sequence 1 of DNA is corresponding to the ith position of the nucleotide in the second DNA sequence. But this is not the case in all of the sequencing problems. And we know that in most of the cases, the ith position of the nucleotide in sequence 1 will not correspond to the ith position of the nucleotide in the sequence 2. And we also know that the mutation is going on all the times in the DNA sequences, and it is an evolutionary process. And during the DNA replication, there are many changes within the DNA, either through a process of deletion, insertion, or substitutions. And we also know that the enzyme that is responsible for DNA replication, that is the DNA enzyme that replicates the DNA, is qualified and very specialized for the proofreading. The polymerases, DNA polymerases, they generally proofread the DNA sequence that is replicated. But still, during the process of replication, there are many changes within the DNA, and due to these processes of substitution, insertion, and deletion, there are changes within the DNA sequences. So the biologists have a rare chance or have the ability to have the knowledge whether the ith symbol or position in one DNA sequence correspond to the ith position of the other DNA sequence. So here we can see that there are two DNA sequences. Number one is ATATATAT, and the other is TATATATA. So we call them as a V, and this is W. So if we use the Hamming distance technique to compare these two sequences, then it is a no use and we will not get the correct answer. So Hamming distance technique cannot be used to compare the DNA sequences. Rather, we can use the other technique, and we can simply shift the second DNA sequence in the right direction. So we can see this is the sequence of the first DNA sequence, and despite writing the T below the A, because this T is the first nucleotide of the second DNA sequence, we have just shifted the T one nucleotide in the right direction. So by simply moving the DNA sequence in the right direction, we come up with the sequence that correspond, and both of these sequences, they are corresponding to each other. So we can say that we have aligned the one I plus one letter in this sequence against the ith letter in the second sequence. And in this case, one is less than or equal to I, and I is less than or equal to 7, because these are the 7 sequences here. So we can also compare the sequence of this DNA with this DNA sequence, and despite there are many subtle similarities within these two sequences. As in the previous case, we see that there are many more similarity, but in this case, the similarity is much lower. But still, we can align this very easily. And for this purpose, we just move the second DNA sequence one alphabet towards the right direction, and four alphabets will become the aligned. And again, we just move the last two alphabets further right, and again we will reach with the alignment. So by using the moving technique, sliding window technique, we can align these two sequences very easily. In this case, we have created a gaps, but these gaps, by creating these gaps, we have aligned the rest of the strings of the DNA sequences.